and I'm backstage at Mercury Shopping Centre in Essex with the wonderful Jasmine Elcock. Welcome.
Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm really good.
Excellent. Now, you've just performed at the shopping centre. Yes. How was it?
It was amazing. Yeah. There was loads of people there. I didn't expect to see that many people, actually, because, you know, they were more mostly shopping and stuff. But, yeah, I did see a few faces that I knew, and it was lovely.
And for you as well, because you've got loads going on at the moment, some things we can't necessarily talk about, but if yes. you tune into ITV, you might be able to see Jasmine there, but I think it's presented by Anna Dex, something like that. But Jasmine, you have already performed at the O2, Indigo O2, haven't you?
Yes.
Which is massive. What was that like?
It was an experience to remember. It was amazing. It was just so big and... Yeah, because it's such a significant place
yeah.
in London, it was amazing. It was an amazing experience.
And that was for Teen Star, wasn't it?
It was, yeah.
So how old were you at that point?
I think I was about 10.
10 years old?
Yeah.
So have you always loved music?
Of course, yeah. Since a very young age, my mum and dad realised that I'd just loved to perform and yeah. I loved the stage, and they sort of knew that I was going to go into this profession.
Yeah.
So, yeah, music's always been a big thing for me.
And your parents are so supportive, aren't they? Have they just constantly, you know, really encouraged you to follow that
yeah,
path?
Yeah, my parents are very encouraging, and I think I need that encouragement, because if I didn't have it, then I don't think I'd be where I am today.
Yeah.
And yeah, they're just really supportive in what I do, so I'm really thankful.
And obviously right now, you're at school and you're doing this as well. Is it quite difficult to kind of juggle studying with performing?
It can get a bit stressful, because, you know, I'm at this stage where I'm doing my GCSE options and I'm trying to figure out what to do. Mm. But I have to try and handle two things. And,
yeah.
You can do it, but it's just a bit stressful. But it's okay.
But I was going to say, you seem really kind of mature in your outlook on things and everything. Because how old are you? Remind me.
I'm 14.
So you're 14 right now, and you're already in such a great position. You played some massive venues, and also, I heard this correctly, have you played for royalty before?
Yes, I have.
And who was that for? Are we allowed to say?
That was for Princess Beatrice, I think.
Wow.
And yeah, up London. It was scary.
Yeah.
But it was really good.
So how did you get involved with that?
I think my dad saw it on the internet, and it was my dad. He booked me in for it.
Dad.
Yeah, it's all
working
dad.
Is magic.
Yeah.
I love that. And with today, obviously, you've been involved with what Gary does. So we've just been raising money for a charity, well, for three charities, Action for Children, British Heart Foundation, Fallen Fusiliers.
Yeah.
Gary's the man that organises all of this. He puts on all the free entertainment, brings music to people in shopping centres, gigs, festivals, fields, wherever we are.
Yeah.
You know, you got involved with that a couple of years ago. What's it like to be part of the Together in Harmony group?
It's amazing. It's just, we sort of just click. Like,
yeah.
There's such a good environment between all of us. And I think as we're all young artists, we're all in this industry where we're just growing.
Mm.
And to do it with people that you know are going to be with you every step of the way, it's a really nice environment that we have.
Excellent. And talking of which, I just heard you sing the new single as well.
Yes.
That you've got going out. Tell us a little bit about that, what it's for and everything.
So it's called We Are One, and there's a group of us with Gary that just sung it before on stage. It's a really good song. It launches on Monday, and that was the first time that we've actually sang it
wow.
in public, and it was videoed, and it was great, yeah.
Oh, cool. And what's that for? What charity is that for?
That's for Child for Child, and that's also going to Switzerland.
Yes, yeah. Brilliant.
Yeah, for the charity of cancer as well, so.
And this isn't just any single, by the way, because I read that it's written by somebody that wrote
Frozen,
yeah. Isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, it was amazing to know that someone like that famous actually wrote a song yeah. for us to do. Yeah.
So exciting. Yeah. Well, listen, you've got a massive year ahead of you. 2016 is going to be big.
Big.
Lots of people already singing your praises out there and saying, oh my goodness, how does that voice come out of her? She's absolutely incredible.
Yeah.
She's so little, but you've got such a like powerful, I say you're little, but she's nearly as tall as me. but you've got such a powerful voice as well.
Thank you.
And obviously just really mature. And I think it's inspirational to find somebody that is 14 years old that already has such a clear direction of where they want to go. So listen, before we do end the interview, just tell us your social media, just in case people want to look you up, Twitter and Facebook.
Yeah, so you can look up my Twitter at jazzyje18@gmail.com.
Nice.
Yeah, a bit long, but nice. I also got Snapchat, Jasmine_Elcock. You can look up my... Yeah, that's about it.
That's enough for us, yeah. I reckon, to get along with. Well, listen, Jasmine,
and also
thank
you can look at my YouTube account as well.
Ooh, yes, do that.
It's just jasmine.elcock.
Excellent. Well, listen, thank you so much.
Thank you.
You've helped us out as always. And yeah, good luck with the year ahead.